The idea itself depends on that we get bookcases, okay, and we put them in monumental areas like mosques, like at the Citadel, Muhammad Ali Mosque, and Ibn Qalawun Mosque, and we have one in Amr ibn al-As, and we put our books, okay. Of course, these books are all revised by Al-Azhar al-Sharif, and we have our volunteers who are very well trained. We stand in the library, we present it to them. We offer them, if they'd like, of course, these are free gifts. We offer them the books. We tell them that if they have any question, if they want to ask us, we offer them cards, emails, and websites, so that we stay in contact with them. And we hope to present a good image of Egypt, the true image of Egypt.
Yes. That we are facing, you know, Islam as a religion. I think there is no such religion or ideology in the entire human history has been into spot like Islam. There is no such book that has been written about Islam through the Orientalists that attack Islam like any other religion in the world. Mm-hmm. So mainly from Japan till Argentina, you know, people have many bad ideas about Islam, and it's our mission, you know, to clarify these misconceptions. So the first challenge that we have is to train our volunteers how to answer about these common misconceptions that has been repeated through about 500 years, you know, since the Orientalism started to invade our countries, you understand? Mm-hmm. So, and I always say, convince yourself before you convince others, because I found out that many Muslims, they still have misconceptions in the religion. So how are you going to conduct the message if you're not fully understanding the point of this issue or that issue, understand? Mm-hmm. So mainly we train the volunteers how to understand the concepts of the religion, how to conduct the message to the different types of people, because we have different culture. We have while you're dealing with a French guy, is completely different while you're dealing with a man from South America, you understand? Other challenges, like we have many volunteers who are very willing to come with us to help us in such volunteer acts. So these are mainly the challenges that we have to face. Challenge to adapt the person who's delivering this message, this vocal message, by his behavior, and then to give him the info, to give him the knowledge. Many Muslims, and they are very good practicing Muslim, but there are many basic information they don't know, especially when they're talking to people.
Most important topic, and the one we are asked so many questions about, women in Islam. Mm. Of course, as a woman,
this is the first book that
yes,
we have in front
exactly.
of us.
This, yani, as a woman, they come to us to talk to us, and once they see us, they see the veil, and they start looking, and they are like cautious to come and ask and talk. And then we smile, we tell them, welcome, please come if you have any question. Then they talk to us as if we are somehow retarded or something. Mm-hmm. Then we start to talk, we start to explain things, and they start, you know, the look into respect. And then they start to ask us, what's your education?
Yes.
And thank God we are mostly, I'm a doctor, and most of our friends there, we are very highly educated. So we tell them, and wow, you are doctors? How come? We tell them
but
that...
But you're talking about this these
tell
days?
Us, were you forced to get married so
yeah.
that your father yeah. forced you to get married? Of course not, nothing like that. So are you not allowed to study or read? Or, of course not, we are allowed. Actually, Islam encourages women to read and to study and to work and everything. And they become amazed. She said, I didn't know this at all. The media at our countries mm-hmm. don't show that. We always show, you know, these people dressed in
yeah,
black
and
fighting.
That's exactly what I want to, how can you market that image outside Egypt?
Well, I believe to have the success or to get the success in your volunteer work, you have to focus such in one area. For instance, there are some people who are proposing us, why not extend our activities to do so and so and so. But this is the first step for failure, you know. Just focus on what you're doing.
Mm.
We are receiving almost further than 10 million tourists per year, you know, before the revolution. So this is a massive number of people, you know, we're receiving. To cover all of them in the airports, in the touristic places, in such a good way with good printed materials and good volunteers, good book stands, it will cost so much. It will cost lots of money, and we will need lots of volunteers. So this is enough work for an association like Ahlam. You know, mainly our activities is how to to present Islam to our people, to the people who are coming to our country. That's why it came the name Ahlan. Ahlan is welcoming people. Welcome to my culture. Welcome to my to know my religion. Welcome to my home. Understand?
We train. We have courses, not just in legal Islamic science. No, we train. We have communication skills training. We have trainings how to train your ethics first, as Engineer Hisham said, how to first apply what Islam teaches us before teaching it to others. And this is very important. We study human development, human resources, how to just deliver the message in the best way possible. In Dawah, we have a Dawah course at Ahlan, and we were given this amazing example. The trainer showed us a picture of a red Ferrari. Of course, the Ferrari is an amazing car. And he asked us, what do you think about this car? We said, amazing, who wouldn't like to drive a Ferrari? And then he showed us another picture of the Ferrari wrecked after an accident. And we were all, and he said, the Ferrari is wrecked. We said, yes. He said, why do you think? We said, the driver must have made a mistake, or another driver must have made a mistake that caused this accident. He said, so it's not the Ferrari's fault. We said, no, it's the driver. A human error must have led to this. It's the same about Islam. Islam is
this
a
is a very interesting example.
Yes, it is. We have amazing trainers. Everyone who will join us will really enjoy the courses. Every da'aya, every caller to Allah, every sheikh, he should know that when speaking in public, he should really put to himself certain standards and to measure through these standards how to deliver the message to people. Okay, and we have the role model, of course, of Muhammad, may peace be upon him. He was the best caller to Allah ever, and we have a course of action that he set on how to call to Allah. Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, okay, one of the most famous Muslim Khalifa, he said, be silent callers to Allah through your ethics, through your attitudes with people. But we have amazing sheikhs, and not just in Egypt, by the way. I'm talking about Bilal Phillips, Sheikh Yusuf Estes. They are amazing callers to Allah. But we have to shed the light on both sides, not just the ones who speak badly.
In general, as I spoke, it's the duty of Ahlan to represent the message of Islam as an association. It's a duty of the individuals of Ahlan, you know. So before I go to Ahlan or go to my volunteer work in Ahlan, I have to be presentable enough of my religion, you know. In our religion, the hygiene is very important, for instance, or how to dress properly. So it's the first duty, how to present your issue, is to how to watch your language, you know, to watch your behavior. There are many processes in which we can achieve to present a good volunteers, you know, to present the issue of Islam to others through Ahlan and through improving yourself, your ethics. So it's not just by a training in one day a week and to show you how to present Islam. No, if the message of Islam is like a shining light, if you don't reflect this light, if the people, they don't see the reflection of this light from your soul, from your face, from the way of your behavior, they will not believe that there is a shining light was being spot at you. I believe that we have a wonderful candidate. We have a wonderful volunteers. We receive many hundreds of people. We want to share us on this.
We have head department for Ahlan, and they always tell us this: you have to be successful in your own lives. You have to study well. If you are a student or something, you have to study well. If you are at work, you have to work real hard. Ahlan cannot affect your work or your degrees or your marks, whatever. If we have, of course, some young students with us as volunteers in Ahlan, and they say you cannot be a representative of Islam if you are not successful.
Thank you.